This is part 5 of a series on XGBoost. In this video, we will analyze the exact greedy algorithm of XGBoost classification in detail. This video was produced in Korean and translated into English, and my voice was generated through AI text-to-speech. In the last video, we looked at the training process and the prediction process for XGBoost classification through a simple example. In this video, we will derive the formulas used in these processes and analyze in detail the algorithm presented in the paper. Let's take a look at the algorithm introduced in the XGBoost paper. Section 2.1 of this paper sets regularized learning objective function and optimizes this objective function to create the formulas that calculate the score, gain, and the output value used in the previous video. In regression, the mean squared error is used for this loss function. We looked at this in detail in this video. In classification, binary cross entropy is used as the loss function. By simply changing the loss function, this algorithm can work as both regression and classification. Optimizing the objective function provides a formula for calculating the output value of each leaf node. Equation 5 is the formula used in the training process in the previous video. Equation 7 is a formula that calculates the gain using the score after splitting the parent node and the score before splitting. This is also the formula we used to find the best split point in the previous video. And this paper proposes algorithm 1 of exact greedy algorithm for split finding. This is what we analyzed in the regression video, and if we just change the loss function, this algorithm works for classification. Let's analyze this in detail. Let's analyze the contents presented in Chapter 2.1 of the paper one by one. Y hat is the predicted probability. It is bounded to 0 and 1. Calculating the odds using the y-hat is as follows. Odds ranges from 0 to positive infinity. Taking the log of both sides of this formula gives us the log of odds. The log odds is unbounded from negative infinity to positive infinity. XGBoost classification uses regression trees to learn the residuals and uses these trees to estimate the log odds and converts the log odds into probabilities. This is to estimate the unbounded log odds by learning the unbounded residuals. This is the same concept as the logistic regression. For more information about this part, please refer to the logistic regression videos. Here the log odds is defined as F. We use the y-hat of the iteration round, t-1, to calculate the log odds f of the round, t-1. And if you add the output value w of the iteration round t to the f of the round t-1, you get the f of the round t. And we can use the logistic function to convert the log odds f into the probability y-hat. Regression uses the mean squared error for the loss function, while classification uses the binary cross entropy. The binary cross entropy can be expressed using the log odds F as follows. We derived this formula in this video of the GBM. Now, as we saw in the regression video, let's define the regularized learning objective function as follows. add a regularization term to the loss function, where the uppercase T is the number of leaf nodes, and W is the output value of a leaf node. For more information on this formula, please refer to this video in regression. Now let's express the loss function as follows. This expression is based on this formula above, and use the binary cross entropy for the loss function. Use the formula above. Our goal is to find W that minimizes this objective function. By differentiating this objective function with respect to W, we can find the optimal W. The first sigma of this objective function is expressed based on the data point number I. And the second sigma is expressed based on the leaf node number J. So the W appears differently in this formula. To differentiate this formula with respect to WJ, we need to convert the first and second WX to WJ expressions. This requires a somewhat complicated process. This is explained in detail in the video. The objective function we looked at on the previous page is as follows. Since this equation is difficult to solve, let's approximate it using a Taylor series. The Taylor series for a two-variable function fx and y is as follows. Let's find the Taylor series for this loss function. The variable x in function f corresponds to y in the loss function, and a is 0. And the variable y corresponds to the logods f, and b corresponds to the output value w. The Taylor series for this loss function is as follows. We find a quadratic approximation of the loss function. The first order partial derivative of the loss with respect to f is defined as g, and the second order partial derivative is defined as h. And use the binary cross entropy for this loss. The objective function can then be approximated in this way. The latter part is the regularization term. Now we want to differentiate this objective function with respect to WJ. This part is independent of WJ. Therefore, we only need to consider this part. Then, the final objective function can be expressed as follows. This is equivalent to that of regression using MSE. Now let's find the G and the H. G is the first derivative of the loss with respect to F. Differentiating this loss with respect to F gives us the following result. And we can write this equation like this. This is a logistic function, and the G can finally be written as follows. This then means the negative residual. This result is equivalent to the G in regression. This time, let's find the H. H is the second derivative of the loss with respect to F. If we differentiate the above result with respect to f again, we get the following result. We can write this equation as follows. And this equation can also be written as below. Then the first part will be 1, and the second and the third parts will both be y hat. Finally, h is like this. When using mean squared error in regression, H was 1. However, in classification using the binary cross entropy, H is this formula. In this regression video, the formula for the output value was derived as follows. In regression, H is 1, so sigma H is the number of residuals. However, in classification, H is this formula. This was the formula for finding the output value of each leaf node in the previous video. And the score values before and after splitting the parent node are calculated as follows. And the gain is calculated as the difference between these scores. Classification uses this value for H. In the previous video, we used this formula to calculate the scores of each leaf node and used this formula for H in the denominator. We also used this formula to calculate the output value of each leaf node and used this formula for H in the denominator. Algorithm 1 presented in the paper can be used for both regression and classification. When calculating the score and the output value, only H is different. Again, H is 1 for regression, and H is this formula for classification. In regression, sigma H is the number of residuals, and in classification, sigma H is this expression. The overall process of this algorithm is the same as regression. We have analyzed the classification algorithm in detail through the content presented in the paper so far. In the next video, we'll implement this algorithm in code from scratch.